back live from Gymnastics of San Antonio. As always, we're going to give it a couple minutes, wait till people join on. Yeah, not much more else to say about that. Just going to wait till people are on. Hello, one person who just joined. We're just waiting a couple minutes to have more than just you on. I always try to wait till at least three people are watching to get started so I'm not just coaching to an empty class. So we'll give it a couple more minutes and then I'll go ahead and get started. Hello, second person who just joined. We're just waiting for one more. I like to have at least three before I get started. Just hang tight. Four. All right, perfect. We'll get going. All right. Hello, world, all four people. Five. Awesome. So we're going to go ahead and get started with our warm-up. Just get those muscles warmed up, moving. Let's do jumping jacks to start out. Just open and close. Let's do this for 30 seconds, starting now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, and 30. That's 30 jumping jacks, approximately 30 seconds. Now let's take it into, let's make it fun. Let's do a side run. So you can do it in kind of a shuffle or a full on run if you want, however you want to do it. I'm just going to do kind of a shuffle, chasse kind of thing. However much space you've got, just use that space. If you don't have a lot of space at all, you can just kind of go in circles, jumping. I don't know. Now go up and down. 1, 2. My shoulders are sore. Eight. 9. 1 more and 10. Awesome. Take your arm just straight across your chest. Grab the wrist. Keep that arm nice and straight and pull it towards your body. Switch sides, grab, cross, grab, and pull. And arms up tall, touch your back, grab your elbow, and pull behind your head. Again, as always, you can also grab your hands for this one. Just trying to get that stretch over in your shoulder. And reach it over to the other side. Good. And let's go ahead and stretch your neck a little bit. I keep forgetting to do this, but I try to. So you're just gonna kind of reach to the side and pull your head very gently. You don't want to go too much. Other side. Look down at your feet. Try to, again, gently pull your head down so you're feeling the stretch in the back of your neck. Okay, rolling side to side. Full circle. Alright. And feet together. Reach down. Try to touch your toes. Good. Take it down to the floor. Butterfly. Ask your little ones, where are we flying to today? I think I'll go to the beach, because why not? I wish I could go there for real. That'd be great. Good. And push those knees down to the ground. And try to touch your nose, your forehead, down to your toes. And together, make sure they're not coming apart or bending. It's very common. I don't blame you, this is hard. But you want to make sure you're getting that stretch. Alright, legs straight out into your straddle. Arms up tall. And we're going to reach over and grab those toes. Try not to let your toes and knee go forward. Try to keep them up as much as you can. Alright, you take it back up. We're going to go onto your knees. Put one leg straight out in front. Ponytail might not work out too well. Alright, hands on your knee and bend into your lunge. As always, pushing those hips forwards. Again, you want to make sure your knee is not in front of your toes. It's super, super bad for your knee. So make sure that your knee is just about directly over your ankle. You should be good. Push those hips. Now straighten your front leg again. Point your toe up towards the ceiling. Hands up by your foot and nose to knee. Good. And go ahead and slide it down to your split. However far you can. Looks like this is as far as I'm going today. As always, that's okay. Hold yourself up wherever you need to be. Oh my goodness. Make sure your toes are pointed, knees are nice and straight. And take it back up. Switch sides, put the other leg out in front. And bend into your lunge. Pushing your hips down. Bow over your ankle and straighten hands by your ankle, nose to knee. Good. And slide it down to your splits. Wow, for once my left is better than my right. Shocker. Alrighty. Sit it up. Your knees, you're going to do your wrists real fast. Let's start with just kind of circling them. Shake it out. Then we're going to go palms up, point them down to the floor, and push your palms down into the ground. You should feel the stretch right here in your forearm. And flip it over. Are we still at 2?
7.
7. Awesome. Hello. Welcome. If you're just joining in, we're just about done with stretches. If you feel like you need to warm your body up a little bit, feel free to go off of what I'm doing and stretch it out a little bit before you get started. All right. Let's do the ankle stretch. I haven't done that in a while. But here's a new one y'all may or may not know. Common in yoga, so if you do yoga, I'm sure you know it. Pretty much a downward dog. You're going to stick your booty up in the air. You push your heels down to the floor. You want to try to get your heels as far as you can. If you're all the way up like this, it's probably not stretching your calf very much. You kind of bend one knee, switch back and forth. Make sure you're getting this muscle back here. Switch. Switch. One more time, switch. Good, and take it down. If you need to stretch your wrist a little more, that's okay. I do. Just kind of making sure you're not going to hurt it as we put weight on it. That's what I did yesterday, is not fun. Alright. Lay down on your back. So you're going to go into bridge. Look down, hands by your ears. Push up. If you can, get your feet together. And if you can, try to get those knees straight. Down, hug your knees, rocking wheel 3 times. 1, 2, and 3. Stand it up. And that is our warm-up. Once again, if you are just joining us, feel free to stretch it out however you need. Don't worry about it. We're all good here. Alright. Look, I messed up my shorts. Alright, this is why you don't wear jeans to gymnastics. Started on beam. Take a second, drink some water. I'm gonna do a bun instead of a ponytail because this just is not working. Keeps sticking to my neck. Deal. And then we're going to do for those of you who do not remember, coupe is simply putting your toe right at your ankle. So we're going to do this hands on your hips. If this is too easy for you and a little more of a challenge, you can do arms out to the side. I'm going to keep it on my hips though. And we're just taking it into a step. If you want more of a challenge, especially since you're not actually on a beam, you can always do these in releve. Try to hold it a little bit with each step. Ah, falling. You do not have to do releve. If you'd rather be flat, that's totally fine. We're going to take it backwards. Same thing. It's kind of hard to do these in releve backwards. Let's not do that. Excellent. Now we're going to take it a little bit higher instead of coupe. Bring your knee all the way up to a passe. This one might be a little difficult to do in releve, so don't worry about it. That's more of an intermediate level walk. You can definitely try it if you want to. I'm not stopping you. Not that I could even if I tried, because here at home. And take it backwards. Again, bringing that foot all the way up to your knee. Make sure your leg is not going out to the side. You want it straight in front of you. Make sure your toe isn't crossing behind or crossing in front. It's right next to your knee. Not on top of it, not behind it. Awesome. All right. Now we're going to do some bunny hops. My personal favorite to do on beam because it engages absolutely everything. Your focus, your legs, your core, everything. So, you're up in releve. It doesn't have to be a full releve. It can just be a slight one, just enough to get your heels off the floor, because bouncing on the balls of your feet is a lot easier than bouncing flat foot. So, slight releve, just hopping. I'm not going to go the full distance on this one. Gonna go here and then backwards. Absolutely feel free to go however far you have. If you don't have a lot of space, that's fine. Use what space you have. Alright, next one that we're gonna do. It's gonna be kind of weird because like I said, I know you don't have a beam. I said I would try to do everything that you can do on a beam, on a floor, but for this one we're just gonna modify it a little bit. It's an ice cream scoop. So y'all have all done these, I'm sure. But instead of scooping and keeping your leg straight, we're gonna bring it around the side. So it's still staying straight, just kind of circle it like that. We can call these something else. If you have an idea of what we could call them in place of ice cream scoop, since we're not really scooping, leave it in the comments, I'll use it. As always, just like in the regular ice cream scoops, you want to make sure you're not leaning over and your weight is staying mostly on, or not mostly, all on that one leg. And we're going to take it backwards, circling front to back instead of back to front. A balancing hold kind of thing, we're going to work on your tendu. So for those of you who don't remember what a tendu is, it's pretty much just touching the floor with your pointed toe. You can hover over the floor if you want to, adds a little more difficulty, totally up to you. I'm going to do it hovering over just because you're just going to hold it. You can do, yeah, let's just hold it for now. Let's count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, oh my goodness, cannot balance. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Switch legs. You're going to put the other one straight out in front. Make sure that leg is straight, toe is nice and pointed. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now we're going to do a back tendu. It's arrow pointed behind you. Again, on this one, you can hover a little over the floor or keep it down. Y'all might recognize this from the backward walks we do on beam. I always ask you to feel for the beam behind you so you don't fall off. This is that condi position that you use for that. So we're just gonna hold it. Count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Switch legs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Now we're gonna add a little bounce to it. So instead of simply holding, I want you to try to kind of bounce your leg up and down. You can do it really high or really small, however you want. I'm gonna do it kind of medium to give both sets time. We're gonna do 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Switch sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. We're gonna do the exact same thing with that back tendu. This one's a little more challenging because it takes more of your back. It's gonna be hot. I'm gonna keep back in front of the fan. There we go. Alright. Leg straight behind you, going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Very nice. Alright. Next thing that we're gonna do kind of a cartwheel drill, kind of a beam drill. I do this on both. It's been a while since I've done this on beam though, but it'll be a good transition over into floor because again, it does kind of sort of help with cartwheels. So what you're gonna do is keep your hands on your imaginary beam, whatever version of that it may be, and you're gonna hop your feet side to side as you move your hands forward. So, if you don't have a line, let's see, what can you do? You can do these in place. You don't have to move forwards. I would prefer if you did, though, because it's working different muscles. So, just try to have some sort of distinguisher of where you're jumping over so that you can make sure you're actually crossing it and not just jumping in the same place. So, like I said, you're going to put your hands down. You're jumping back and forth as you move forwards. Might not want to sit for this one. Okay, ready? And we're going to take it backwards, same way. Oh, this is a lot harder backwards than I thought it'd be. That's hard. My goodness. I hope you liked that because I did. That was fun. I'm going to make you do that when we come back. Like I said, that is our last thing on beam. We're going to transition over the floor. Go ahead and grab some water. Kind of don't want to leave right here. The fan feels nice. Over to floor. I am burning already. I'm going back over there with fans. Where can I feel the fan? I can feel this fan. This works. Alright. So. First things first. So we're going to start with handstands. So you can do these in whatever version you want. If you have your couch at home, you can put your feet up on the couch. You can use your wall if you have space. You can use parent if they're there to hold you up, if you have the strength to hold it yourself. I'm going to attempt and most likely fail to not use anything because I'm in the middle of the floor so that I can be in front of the fan. If this fails as badly as I'm expecting it to, I'll bring the block over and use that as my couch. Actually, you know what? Let's take the injection and go ahead. But I'm going to assume that you do. So, feet up on your couch. You can use the rail thing or the cushion. Hopefully your parents are okay with this because we're not jumping on or anything. So, hands down. You're going to try to get your hips all the way over your hands. If you can't quite do this, that's okay. Walk it out. Go wherever you need to do. One, two. Back roll drills. If you can already do your and do some drills for it. Because what I notice a lot in my little ones and my beginners is that it's hard to get your hips up and over your head. And once you're there, it's even harder to stand it up. So what we're gonna do is practice sitting. I know that sounds silly. Practice sitting, what? Well, it's different when you're sitting for a back roll, because anyone can sit. Anyone can do that. But for sitting with a back roll, you have to start pushing yourself back into your roll before you're even down on the ground. So to practice that, first thing we're gonna do is simply squat down to the floor. No real sitting there. We're just practicing the arms. So you go down and bring your arms down. Notice I'm up on my toes. Okay, that's kind of where you want to be. We're gonna do that again. Up, just bring it down. Hands by your ears, ready to go. One more time, ready? And bring it down. All right, from here, once you're in this position, this is when you start pushing with your feet. So as you roll back, you don't want to just plop on your bottom and expect gravity to bring you over. That's not how gravity works. Gravity takes you down, not up and over. So you need the momentum to push yourself back. So as we sit, you're going to kind of go back, just a little bit. You don't want to throw yourself on the ground, especially because I doubt you're on a nice soft surface like our floor. So it's just kind of a soft sit to the back of your bottom. So you're not sitting like this, but like kind of here, okay? So let's try it from all the way up. So you start here, sit, and to your bottom. If you're landing right, then you should automatically roll back. I should have mentioned in the beginning, go to a soft surface. Don't want to do this on tile. Or wood. Alright, one more time, just the roll, starting here, sit, and back. Okay, notice as I go back, my hands stay by my ears. If I were to stay in this position right here, I'd be okay. So I like to call these pizza hands. Because when I teach back rolls, I usually teach it on a wedge like this. If you're a cheese fanatic like me, you know this looks like a giant wedge of cheese. So what I always say is that it is a giant wedge of cheese, and these are your pizzas. And as you're going into your roll, you want your pizzas to be nice and cheesy, because who likes pizza without cheese? It's what makes the pizza. So no matter what kind of pizza it is, it always has cheese. So you got your pizzas, you got your cheese. Now, I don't know about you, but when I'm trying to get a lot of something, you don't just like lightly dabble it. That's not going to get a whole lot. You got to squish it, right? So that's what your hands, your pizzas do to your cheese. As you're going to your back row, you push as hard as you can. That's how you get off your head. If you're just lightly going, getting a little bit of cheese on there, you're not going to get all the way over. It's just not how it works. So you got to sit and push, explode off those hands. Push as hard as you can. Now obviously I know y'all probably don't have a cheese mat at home, so all you're gonna do is practice that push, unless you do have some kind of soft surface that you're willing to do a back roll on. Feel free to practice that. If not, what you're gonna do is sit on your knees, bring your chest to the floor, and push. Try to explode off the floor, okay? So it's like jumping, but with your hands. So you're practicing that push. Even better if you have some kind of horizontal surface. You can kind of pretend to be upside down and push as hard as you can. All right, so you're gonna practice that push a couple times. Do it 5 times, and I'm gonna get some water while you do that. Just about done with those pushes, and we're gonna start on our next thing, which is a candlestick. So this is what I was talking about with the up and over motion. Now again, obviously we are not doing a full back roll because I don't want you to hurt your heads on your hard floors if that's what you have. If you do have a soft floor, like I keep saying, obviously feel free to do them. I'm just looking out for those who don't and letting you have, giving you some options. So, you're gonna do what we did before. You start up, sit, roll to your back, and you're gonna lift your feet up, lift your hips off the floor, just like that, over and over. some water. You want to stay hydrated. Okie dokie. That should be enough time to get your water. So here's what we're gonna do for trampoline. So first things first, I want you to just jump like you would on a long tumble track. So whatever space that you have is what I'm trying to say. Whatever space you have, just use that. You're literally just going to jump. You can do stretch jumps, you can run, jump kind of thing, like you do on tramp, whatever kind of run you want to do. You can skip, you can bounce, you can jog, I don't care, just run. Going down and back, that's it. Should be enough time for that. So for trampoline, what we're gonna do is play a game, kind of game thing. If you don't have anyone to play with, that's okay. You can just practice the jumps and positions and play with yourself. Not a big deal. If you do have someone to play with, it's pretty much just taking turns, so it's not that big of a difference. So what you can do with your partner, if you have one, is kind of take turns doing it and tell your partner what they could do better. It's not trying to focus on what's wrong or anything. And in that spirit, you're going to tell them one thing that was really, really great about their jump, or something that was like just decent, whatever. You want to make it positive, and tell them something that they could fix. So for example, if I did a stretch jump like this, I would tell you, my partner, me, that my arms were really good. They were nice and high in my ears, but it's a stretch jump, so my knees aren't supposed to be bent. So then I would take that criticism and do it again. I'm going to leave my arms how they were because my partner said they were really good, but this time I'm going to keep my legs straight. Ta-da! You fixed it. So you're kind of playing coach here. So first thing you're going to do is exactly what I just did, a stretch jump. So for those of you who don't know what a stretch jump is, it's what I just showed you. Arms up, legs straight, just going straight up into the air. I'm going to give you a couple seconds to each do that, give each other feedback. If you don't have a partner, then this is a really good drill for just self-awareness. You're figuring out, okay, that didn't feel quite right. I should fix that. So you want to pay attention to what you know it's supposed to be like and try to get that all by yourself. If you have a mirror, even better, you can watch yourself. Do it. I'm not sure why I keep saying that they're like themselves. I don't think they're on a basement, they had a camera. Anyway, I guess for the YouTube people who watch it later, that's why I'm doing it. Okay. Alright, next one that you're gonna do is a tuck jump. So you can do this one with your hands on your hips or up in your ears, just like the stretch jump. On this one, the important thing to focus on is getting your knees up to your tummy and not back to your butt. I wish I had a better way to say that. Sorry, for those of you who don't like the word, I apologize. So I'm gonna do it here because it's easier on the floor. Up and land. If you want an extra challenge, you can do it how we do on vault with your stick position. So you're going up, and immediately knees bent, chest up, arms out. And that gives you one more thing to look for when you're giving your good and bad. bad's not a good word. Strength and growth. There we go. So I'll show you one more time. Just like that, or without the freeze. So some examples of what you could look for here is hands leaving the hips, knees going down instead of up, landing on straight legs, toes not being pointed. If you're doing the stick, then if you're landing like crazy, I don't know. All right, next one, do your straddle jump. So for this, it's hands on your hips or out to the side. And you're gonna jump and land feet all the way back together because they come out and back. I'm not, I guess I should, okay. So your hands are here and you're landing all the way back together. What you're looking for here, if your arms are out to the side, you wanna make sure they're not going Flappy Bird style. They're staying out to the side like an airplane. If you're doing hands on your hips, again, just like those tuck jumps, you're making sure they're not going away. You'd be surprised how often we see that. We'll do a shuttle jump. I don't know why, but it happens. So that's something to be aware of. Also with the legs, you want to make sure toes are staying pointed, legs are nice and straight, and you're coming all the way back together. This is not a full shuttle jump. This is not a full shuttle jump. This is not a full shuttle jump. Okay? Back together. And also, landing on bent knees. You never, ever, ever want to land on straight legs. So, as you're giving your partner their strength and growth, you're looking for those things, telling them what they did really good and what they could fix a little bit. Difficult. I don't know if everyone will have done this in class before, so if you're struggling with it, no freak out, it's not a big deal, especially because it might be new for you. So for this one, we're pretty much doing the splits that we normally do in warm-up as a jump. So you're trying to get your front and your back leg up the same distance off the floor. Again, your hands can be on your hips or straight out to the side. So you're looking for the same thing there. You want to make sure you're not going Flappy Bird style and your hands aren't coming off your hips. You're also looking to make sure your front foot and your back foot are in the same place. So if your jump looks like this, then a growth would be to keep your, bring your legs up the same height. Again, same thing if it's the other way around, like that. You want to go same approximate distance. So, and you can do that on both legs. So start with one, going up and down, then you can switch and do the same jump with the other leg in front. Give me a couple seconds to share your growth and strength with that. And we're almost done. looking forward to hopefully playing that when we get back, because I can imagine it being a lot of fun with my classes. I love giving y'all the reins and becoming, like, getting that awareness of identifying yourself or your friends of what they could fix. I've done it before with my intermediates and it went really well, so I'm sure it'd go really good for my beginners too. Alright, so for our game, all you need is something to jump over and something to mark the beginning, or vice versa, the movable object and a stationary object, or two movable objects, totally up to you, whatever you've got laying around. So for example, I would use maybe this line on the ground as my starting and have, I don't know where the jump ropes went, have a jump rope or a sock or marker or blanket, t-shirt, chalk, I don't know, anything that you have laying around. And what you're going to do is start with it nice and close. So I'm going to use my water bottle. Not the best thing in the world, but I'm going to start with it that close. And I'm going to start, use, like I said, my line as the start. So start however much of a run you want. You're going to run, try to jump the distance, and land on 2 feet for now. And then if you made it, you move your marker a little bit farther and do it again. Start back here, run, land on 2 feet, made it, and go a little farther. Until you can't make it anymore. So I'm going to pretend like I can't make this one. Oh, I fell short. So at this point, you would not try to land on 2 feet, but rather leap across and land on 1 foot. So just run. So you're just increasing the distance as you go to your personal ability. If you have a friend to play with, then, or a parent or sibling, whatever, then you can kind of make it a contest, see who can go the farthest, like a jumping limbo. So that is all I have for you. If you have any questions about the game, I can give you some modifications if you want. You can play this outside. You can do this from standing on both feet to jumping to both feet, running like I did. Lots of ways you can change it up. So, hope you enjoyed my class.